Hello everyone. In this section, we trace the growth of mainframe systems from simple batch systems where the computer runs one and only one application to time-shared systems which allow for user interaction with the computer system. Like as you can see, the first of the operating system, that is the batch operating system. So as in case of DOS operating system, you can see it was the operating system wherein only one application can get executed at a time. So any other user programs want to get executed from the computer system, it has to wait for a certain amount of time until the current going program completes its task on the system. So because of that, eventually a lot of time is wasted, because if the memory is also enough, as we know that any program that is to be executed through the computer system, it has to first reside in the main memory, right? So even if the main memory is available, but even if the main memory is available to accommodate the user program, okay, but the DOS operating system can able to execute only one program, means it can, you know, reside only, it can load only one particular program at a time in the main memory. Even if the main memory is available, no other program can be accommodated in the main memory, right? So this is one of the difficulty with the DOS operating system, right? So to overcome with this particular difficulty, okay, batch operating system was introduced. So similarly, we can say the earlier computer systems were physically enormous. They were physically enormous machines run from a console, wherein the common input devices were the card reader and the tape drives. Whereas in case of the output devices, the common output devices were the line printer and the tape drives. Okay, wherein the user did not interact with these systems directly. Okay, the user did not interact directly with the computer system, right? So once if the program is fed into the computer system, right, it is the job of now onwards, it is the job of the computer system to, you know, execute the program until it is completely, you know, done, right? So if there is any once if the program is fed into the computer system, there is no you know, input again can be taken from that particular, you know, task, that particular job. So until it is completed, there will be no interaction between the user and the computer system, right? So to overcome with this difficulty, and also to overcome with the difficulty wherein the DOS operating system was able to execute only one program, now there is a improvement or upgradation made into the technology, okay, in terms of batch system. So in this, jobs which are of similar type are grouped together and treated as a batch, okay? But in the early days computer system, even if those operating systems wherein only one program was executed at a time, even if two programs are of similar type, okay, they cannot be, you know, put into the memory for execution further through the computer system. But with the introduction of the batch operating system, it is now possible, okay, it was possible at that time to, you know, group those similar types of jobs in a batch, or the jobs with the similar requirements were put in a group called as batch, and the entire batch was, you know, submitted to the computer system, right? So computer system later, it can execute the jobs in sequential manner and provides the result to the respective user, right? So here you can see they are stored on the punched cards. The jobs were put on the punched cards. That is a stiff paper in which digital data is stored and presented, represented using some specific sequence of holes. So the similar kind of example you can see in case of OMR sheets, right? So as we know, OMR, each and every person is issued with the OMRs. They have to enter their respective data into the OMR. They have to encircle the respective circles, and they have to submit it to the clerical department. Likewise here, the input is taken in terms of the punched cards, and after collecting the inputs from different users, a collector was used to collect those jobs. And collector, in terms of collector, we can see it as the operator. Operator used to collect all those similar types of jobs, okay, in a batch, and the entire batch was submitted to the computer for further processing. So once if the processing is being done in sequential manner, then the result were provided back to the operator. The operator used to sort those jobs and submits it to or responses back to the respective user. So this is how a batch operating system can be used to execute the jobs with the similar requirements in sequential manner. Okay, so taking the same example as in case of the OMR sheets. Okay, so OMR sheets, each sheet is given to each particular student, and they are asked to fill that particular OMR. So whenever they are done, okay, they have to submit it to the clerical department. So the clerical department will carry that particular batch, or we can say the collected forms from each student is grouped in a batch, right? So the entire batch was submitted to the computer system there, right? So the computer system processes the job one after the other, and the result later will be provided to the operator, and the operator or the clerical department, and the clerical department will submit the result back to the respective user there. So that was one of the example of batch operating system. Okay. Similarly, we can see some of the advantages. Suppose a job takes a very long time. Okay. So usually the processing of these batch operating system was too high, right? Here you can say, suppose a job takes a very long time, maybe 1 day, 1 month or so, then such processes can be performed even in the absence of human being, right? So they have to leave their jobs, they have to leave their they have to leave their batches, okay, to the computer system, and the computer system, after performing the task, it will be provided back to the respective user, okay, even in the absence of human being, the job was performed by the system. Okay, so the execution time of these batch system was too high. Okay, the second advantage is they don't require any special hardware and system support to input the data, right? So it is up to the computer system to execute one program, and after executing that program, it is the job of the computer system and the operating system to feed the next job automatically into the computer system to execute. So like that, one after the other, the jobs gets executed from the computer system. Similarly, there are disadvantages in case of batch operating system. It is very difficult to debug batch system. Okay, means what? If there is any error, you know, generated by the batch system, it was difficult to debug. Similarly, lack of interaction between user and the operating system. The lack of interaction between user and the operating system. Meaning of this is what? Once if the job is fed into the computer system, it is all up to the operating, all up to the operating system. Okay, to look after that particular job. Okay, if there is any problem, then it is the job of the batch operating system to handle it. Okay. So in that way, there will be lack of interaction between the user and the operating system. Similarly, an error occurs in one of the jobs of a batch, then all the remaining jobs get affected. That is, they have to wait until the error is resolved. Okay. So if there is any error generated in the batch, then the remaining, you know, jobs get affected. They have to wait until the error is resolved by the batch operating system. Okay, they simply cannot execute further. Okay, until that currently executing the job gets resolved, the remaining programs or remaining jobs have to wait for some amount of time, certain amount of time, you can say. Right. So this is what the brief part in case of this batch operating system. Okay, thank you.